All the metadata in the world doesn't help if we would never actually build the widget provider. This is the class that has the logic for building the view for the widget and passing it on to the launcher app. It does that through the use of a special class, remote views. Because these views need to go across applications and break their traditional sandbox provided for each app, only a subset of the normal views are supported for widgets, and no custom views are allowed. Thankfully, all of the common views you use in normal Android view layouts are available to your widgets. In fact, you'll build your widget layouts in XML just the same as you would for any other layout in your app. One caveat with widgets has to do with margins. Prior to Android 4, Ice Cream Sandwich, widgets needed to provide their own margins so that widgets wouldn't appear huge next to the app icons already on the home screen. On Android 4.0 and higher, however, the margins are automatically applied for you, and your background should fill the entire space. To make our widget backward compatible, we can wrap our widget in a frame layout that includes the correct padding for each API level. So what does this mythical app widget provider class we've talked about actually do? The core of it is in the onUpdate method. This is where we, surprisingly, update our widgets. You'll get a list of app widget IDs, unique identifiers for each widget the user has created, and it's your job, should you choose to accept it, to update all of those widgets. Thankfully, that's pretty easy for static widgets. Create your remote views object and pass it on to the app widget manager you're given. But even that's not very useful. The setOnClickPendingIntent method allows you to control what happens when you tap on your widget. The only final piece we need to get our widget up and running is an entry in the Android manifest that ties our app widget provider to our app widget provider info. You'll note the app widget update action here. That's what tells Android that this is a widget provider. And our metadata attribute is what tells Android where to find the metadata it needs to display the widget in the widget selection screen. With all those pieces in place, we should be able to get a basic widget showing up on the home screen.